Looking at the southern flank of the Kilauea volcano in Hawaii, you can spot a number of towering cliffs that descend towards the ocean, with individual sections of cliff tops being up to 500 meters or 1,640 feet higher than the landscape below. While quite stunning, these mark the site of fault scarps caused by the slow movement of a wide swath of land towards the ocean. Every year, a large swath of land moves an average of approximately 3 inches or 8 centimeters towards the shoreline. Known as the Hilina Slump, this steady landslide has led some people to speculate that this large swath of land will all of a sudden eventually collapse into the ocean at once, generating a Pacific-wide tsunami. So, is there any evidence which suggests that this will occur anytime soon? The quick answer to this question is no. Not only is a massive landslide where the entire Hilina Slump block moves hundreds or even thousands of feet currently deemed to be incredibly unlikely in the next decade, but such a megaslide is also highly unlikely to occur for the next 1,000 or even 10,000 years if it was to even ever eventually occur in the first place. In other words, the odds of it occurring in the next 1,000 years are pretty close to zero, but not directly zero. With this being said, it is true that large landslides appear to be a part of some island shield volcanoes, including many in the Hawaiian Islands. For example, more than a dozen such megaslides have occurred via collapses across the Hawaiian island chain during the last 10 million years. One such megaslide occurred approximately 1.3 million years ago on the northern section of the island of Oahu, where several thousand cubic kilometers of the Ku'ulau volcano slid into the ocean, which created the large and steep cliffs on Oahu's northern half. So, why is a large and devastating megaslide not also expected in the short-term future due to a collapse of the entirety of the Hilina Slump? The answer is surprisingly the Hilina Slump landslide block itself. In simple terms, the Hilina Slump exists due to magma movement and dike propagation at Kilauea's summit and its two rift zones, which slowly push the affected area towards the ocean. This is what a cross-section of the Hilina Slump looks like. It consists of volcanic rock which overlies the older underlying oceanic crust. Since this landslide has been ongoing for so long, and due to the bend of the oceanic crust which tilts upwards away from Kilauea's summit when going towards the ocean, it has caused a section of the slide to be pushed upwards, aka uplifted, forming a ridge. Per a direct quote from a U.S. Geological Survey webpage, this ridge acts as a backstop, making it more difficult for the large Hilina Slump to slide. This is similar to how a bookend prevents books from sliding down a shelf. However, this isn't to say that tsunamis generated by the Hilina Slump are impossible, as in the last 200 years, large earthquakes have generated at least 3 tsunamis due in part to the movement of this slump. This occurred with varying wave heights in 1868, 1975, and 2018, where the 2018 event only produced a small tsunami. It is my opinion that an earthquake of a magnitude 6.5 or higher along the Hilina Slump can generate a tsunami, although it can also theoretically occur with lower magnitude quakes, but this is much less likely than during a higher magnitude quake, and magnitude 7.0 and higher quakes along the slump are likely to generate a tsunami, but not guaranteed to. To see an example of a larger tsunami generated by an earthquake, I present details surrounding 1975's magnitude 7.2 earthquake. This event caused a wide swath of Kilauea's southern flank to slide towards the ocean, moving as much as 11 feet or 3.4 meters. This landslide subsequently displaced ocean water, and as a section of the landslide was underwater, a part of it was also uplifted, generating a tsunami with wave heights of up to 45 feet per the U.S. Geological Survey. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank DW for becoming a new channel member on YouTube to Geology Hub.